Welcome to From Episode to Episode, I'm your host, Beats. Let's start with the Book of Boba Fett. I can't say whether episode 7, In the Name of Honor, is a worthy culmination of what has been building up since the beginning, because I never got invested in the overarching story. It's not a bad show, it's just unremarkable. That being said, I thought that The Mandalorian's first season was decent yet forgettable, and I thought its second season was great. Maybe this show will also improve when it comes back with new episodes. Well, if it comes back, there hasn't been an official confirmation as of this recording. I don't know what ideas the writers have in store, and I want to give them the benefit of the doubt, but it's hard considering that they killed off a character as cool as Cad Bane. No, I don't know that much about him because I haven't seen most of the Star Wars animated shows. My opinion is based on what I saw here. Why not have him be the antagonist of the entire show? Or at least have him stick around for one more season. The poor schmuck didn't even last 3 episodes. Whoever gets chosen as the big bad has some big shoes to fill. And that's not the only questionable narrative choice, because the Mandalorian and Grogu have reunited, retroactively ruining the scene where they said goodbye. That moment has no dramatic impact anymore. In fact, if I rewatch it now, it will probably feel drawn out. Was this the plan from the start? Then why not present it as a cliffhanger? By the way, are you one of those people who think that the Disney purchase have made the franchise more childish? Well, Jesus! Next up, Tales of the Walking Dead. It's an anthology where each episode is self-contained. I assume these are scenarios that wouldn't work with the characters of the original Walking Dead and Fear the Walking Dead, and the writers didn't want to discard them. I feel like those two shows have run out of ideas, so how can more spin-offs be a solution? Well, any show can be good when the right pieces are in their place. I don't know how this one will be as a whole, but episode 2, Blair Gina? Oh boy! It takes place when the zombie apocalypse is just starting. Each time these two women die, the day is reset and only they are aware of it. What? This fictional world has existed for over 10 years. You can't just introduce an element like this out of nowhere and expect viewers to accept it. Of course that zombies aren't real, but these ones exist because of a virus. It's a grounded explanation. This kind of time loop, on the other hand, is pure fantasy. There isn't even a machine causing it. It's just one of those cases where the universe wants certain individuals to learn a lesson. That usually works when the time loop is the only unusual event in an otherwise everyday setting, but the freaking zombies are taking over the planet! Plenty of characters in this franchise evolved precisely because the end of the world gave them a new perspective. You don't need any gimmicks. Maybe you're thinking about Edge of Tomorrow. And yeah, the time loop happened during an alien invasion, but that's because the movie was meant to feel like a video game. The protagonist kept dying and learning from each experience so he could win the war. That's not to say he didn't have a personal arc, but his values weren't the main focus. Here, with every reset, Blair and Gina learn how to survive, but only this specific day. They don't learn how to stop the apocalypse. Maybe it wouldn't have bothered me so much if I had been entertained, but the plot and the characters are just meh. For the record, you can make a new installment in a franchise that's part of a separate continuity. It's just that you should make it as clear as possible. Imagine a narrator saying that each episode is a parallel universe or an alternate reality. Anyway, I eventually made peace with the fact that this whole show wasn't going to be canon. But then they showed a preview for the next episode, the backstory of Alpha, a character from the original show. So this is canon? Ugh, I have a headache. One last thing, the actors get the starring credit despite appearing in just one episode. It has to do with agents and contracts. American Horror Stories does the same thing, but at least in that show, everyone is listed together, except for the minor roles, which get the co-starring credit at the end. Here, there's both the starring and the guest starring credit. Is it based on the importance of the role or how famous the actor is? Well, it's not a mistake, just a pet peeve of mine. That's it for now. If you want to support me, you can go to Ko-fi or Patreon and you'll get some benefits, including early access. Please subscribe to this channel and I'll see you later.